Good afternoon and welcome from across the church and across our synod as we gather today for the beautiful service of nine lessons and carols in honor of the 12 days of Christmas. It is a particular joy to be in this place of grace, Jerusalem Evangelical Lutheran Church at the corner of Bel Air Road and Moravia in Baltimore City, a congregation that is entering its 180th year of life and ministry in this place. The service today will be exquisitely beautiful, and it is enhanced by those who have lent their hearts, their talents, and their voices to our worship service. Many thanks to those who will read the lessons, our many musicians who have added their gifts and their joy to the celebration, friends from other congregations, Whitestone Baptist Church, Journey of Faith, Triumph Christian Church and Ministries, St. Philip's Evangelical Lutheran Church on Caroline Street in Baltimore, and of course the many people here at Jerusalem Evangelical Lutheran Church as well. A special word of thanks to Mr. David Wright, who is the vicar of Jerusalem Church, who coordinated the service and invited all of us to this beautiful table that this congregation has set. As we enter into worship, there are opportunities for us to continue to worship together. I invite you to add your prayer concerns to the comments online, and also to remember the opportunities to give and to share your time, your talent, and your treasure in the local congregation and beyond. And so if you would like to make a gift this day, go to dembsynod.org and click give. But as for now, let us prepare our hearts and our minds to enter more fully into the Christmas mystery as we enter now into worship.
Beloved in Christ, be it this Christmas season our care and delight to prepare ourselves to hear again the message of the angels, in heart and mind to go even unto Bethlehem, see this thing which has come to pass, and with the shepherds and the wise men adore the child lying in his mother's arms. Let us read and mark in Holy Scripture the tale of the loving purpose of God from the first days of our disobedience unto the glorious redemption brought us by this holy child. And let us make this sanctuary dedicated to his glory and majesty glad with our carols and prayers. But first, let us pray for the needs of this whole world, for peace on earth and goodwill over all the earth, for unity and fellowship within Christ Jesus' Holy Catholic Church that he came to build, within the United States of America, across our entire Delaware, Maryland Synod, and in each congregation, within the city of Baltimore, and in the hearts and minds of all those who worship Christ as Savior and Lord. And because it will rejoice his heart, let us remember at this time the poor and the helpless, the cold, the hungry, and the oppressed, the sick in body and in mind, and those who that mourn, the lonely and the unloved, the aged and the little children, all who now need most the comfort of the Lord Jesus. Lastly, let us remember before God all those who rejoice with us, but upon another shore and in a greater light, that multitude which no man can number, whose hope was in the Word made flesh, and with whom in the Lord Jesus we forevermore are one. These prayers and praises let us humbly offer up to the throne of heaven and the words which Christ himself has taught us to pray.
Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Thank you. lost the light of paradise, that his seed will bruise the serpent's head. And they heard the voice of the Lord God walking in the garden in the cool of the day. And Adam and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God amongst the trees of the garden. And the Lord God called unto Adam and said unto him, Where art thou? And he said, I heard thy voice in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, and I hid myself. And he said, Who told thee that thou wast naked? Hast thou eaten of the tree whereof I commanded thee that thou should not eat? And the man said, The woman whom you gave to be with me, she gave me of the tree, and I did eat. And the Lord God said unto the woman, What is this that thou hast done? And the woman said, The serpent beguiled me, and I did eat. And the Lord God said unto the serpent, Because thou hast done this, thou art cursed above all cattle, and above every beast of the field. On thy belly shalt thou go, and dust shalt thou eat all the days of thy life. And I will put enmity between thee and the woman, and between thy seed and her seed. And it shall bruise thy head, and thou shalt bruise his heel. And unto Adam he said, Because thou hast hearkened unto the voice of thy wife, and hast eaten of the tree of which I commanded thee, saying, Thou shalt not eat of it. Cursed is the ground for thy sake. In sorrow shalt thou eat of all the days of thy life. Thorns also and thistles shall it bring forth to thee, and thou shalt eat the herb of the field. In the sweat of thy face shalt thou eat bread, till thou return unto the ground, for out of it wast thou taken. For dust thou art, and unto dust shalt thou return. Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God. shall. And there shall come forth a rod out of the stem of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. And the Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord, and shall make him of quick understanding in the fear of the Lord, which righteousness shall judge the poor and reprove with equity for the meek of all the earth. The wolf shall also dwell with the lamb, and the leopard shall lie down with the kid, and the calf and the young lion and the fat one all together. And the little child shall lead them, and the cow shall bear, shall feed, and the young one shall lie down together, and the lion shall eat straw like the ox, and the suckling child will play the hole of the ass, and the weaned child shall put his hand on the cockatrice's den. They shall not hurt nor destroy in all my holy mountain, for the earth shall be full of the knowledge of the Lord, just as the waters covers the sea. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God into a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin espoused to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And the angel came in unto her and said, Hail, thou that art highly favored, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women. And when she saw him, she was troubled at his saying, and cast in her mind with manner of salutation this should be. And the angel said unto her, Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with God. And behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb and bring forth a son, and shall call his name Jesus. He shall be great, and shall be called the Son of the Highest. And the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David. And he shall reign over the house of Jacob forever. And of his kingdom there shall be no end. Then said Mary unto the angel, How shall this be, seeing I know not a man? And the angel answered and said unto her, The Holy Ghost shall come upon thee, and the power of the Highest shall overshadow thee. Therefore also that holy thing which shall be born of thee shall be called the Son of God. And Mary said, Behold, the handmaid of the Lord, be it unto me according to thy word. And the angel departed from her. And this is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Beloved, all grace, mercy, and peace be yours and mine, from God and from our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
The American writer Leslie Leland Fields writes of this day, Let the stable still astonish. Straw, dirt floor, dull eyes, dusty flanks of donkeys, oxen, crumbling, crooked walls, no bed to carry that pain. And then the child, rag wrapped, laid to cry in a trough. Who would have chosen this? Who would have said, yes, let the God of all the heavens and earth be born here in this place? Who? Who but the same God who stands in the darker, fouler rooms of our hearts and says, Yes, let the God of heaven and earth be born in this place. The first time I read this short poem, it captivated me. How true it is that the same God who chose to be born and placed in a feeding trough would choose to make a home in my heart. A heart that is burdened by what I have done. And so close to my mind this day, what I have left undone as well. I'm not saying woe is me, feel sorry for me, but admitting that this is the reality God encounters in so many of us, especially come Christmas. Come Christmas, when we've grown tired and worn down, and at least in my case, we find ourselves drowning in a myriad of messes, largely of my own making. Let the stable still astonish. I'm enraptured by how Fields reminds us that God could have left the world to stew in its own mess, but didn't. I love that God could have and probably should have left you and me to our own devices to figure a way out of our own self-created disasters. But God doesn't. There are many storm clouds this last year, clouds that hang ominously over our weary world, clouds that some of us feel have cast shadows, causing problems at work, at school, and at home. Clouds that have become heavy with the grief that overwhelms, with anger that binds us, fears that threaten to overtake us. Big clouds, like COVID, like oppressive systems of disenfranchisement. The chasms that have erupted in communities and families, divisions so raw and infected, it's hard to believe that there is any hope of healing or change or a future, much less the reality different from the reality of our present. But still we make our pilgrimage to the stable. And in that stable, an astonishing scene unlike anyone could have ever expected millennia ago. In that stable, God wrapped in the flesh and blood of a newborn, nothing less than hope. In Jesus, God embodies a new vision of community. In Jesus, God gives us renewed hearts for the neighbor. In Jesus, God gives us a Savior who is Christ the Lord. And that hope, that new hope, that hope has a way of cutting through the hard places in our lives, bringing us into the dawn of a new day for our souls, and calling us forward into a future that is not entirely known, but a future that is certain and secure. Christmas is where this hope started, where love blessed us to begin again. And if it hasn't astonished you yet this year, I invite you to have another look, to see in that stable the grace and love of God. See their hope. Real hope for this day. And for all the days, for all that the days and the years will bring. To know the hope that is Jesus Christ, who was born for you and me, and born in us all, for such a time as this. There's still hard work to be done, dear ones, but it begins here. Let the stable still astonish. Yes, let the God of heaven and earth be born here, in this place. Let us pray. O holy child of Bethlehem, descend to us, we pray. Cast out our sin and enter in, be born in us today. We hear the Christmas angels, their great glad tidings tell. O come to us, abide with us, our Lord, Emmanuel.
those days, that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed, and all went to be taxed, every one into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. Thanks be to God.
The shepherds go to Bethlehem. And there were the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men." And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said one to another, "Let us now go even unto Bethlehem, and see this thing which is come to pass, which the Lord hath made known to us." And they came with haste, and found Mary and Joseph, and the babe lying in a manger. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east to Jerusalem, saying, where is he that is born king of the Jews? For we have seen the star of the east, and are come to worship him. When Herod the king had heard these things, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and the scribes of the people together, he demanded them of them where Christ should be born. And they said unto him, in Bethlehem of Judea. For thus it is written by the prophet, and thou Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, art not the least among the princes of Judah. For out of thee shall come a governor that shall rule my people in Israel. Then Herod, when he had privily called the wise men, inquired of them diligently what time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem and said, go and search diligently for the young child, and when ye have found him, bring me the word again, that I may come and worship him also. When they heard the king had they departed, and lo, the star, which they saw in the east, went before them, till it came and stood over them, where the young child was born. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceedingly great joy. And when they were come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary and his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented him gifts of gold and frankincense and myrrh. And being warned of God in a dream they should not return to Herod, they departed into their own country another way. Thanks be to God. Thank you.
St. John unfolds the great mystery of the Incarnation. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not a thing made that was made. In him was light, and the light was the light of men. And the light shineth in the darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. The same came for witness, to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. That was the true light, which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them gave he the power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor the will of the flesh, nor the will of man, but of God. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. And we beheld his glory, the glory as of only the begotten Son of the Father, full of grace and truth. Thanks be to God.
Beloved, may you know the joy of the angels, the amazement of the shepherds, the faithfulness of Joseph and Mary, the determination of the Magi, and the astonishing love of the Christ child. May Almighty God, Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit bless you now and forever.
Amen.